Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Summer. I want you guys to listen to this lady, right, about guys that especially those living abroad, that their wife have a baby and they have to get a visa for their mother, for Omugwo, right? And the men choose their own mothers rather than their wife's mother. And the truth is, you know what, actually listen to this, right, and I'll come back and say what I want to say.
Dear African men, before you come for me, make sure you watch this video to the end. I have tried to ignore this topic, but I think it's about time. I know God wants me to talk, so I will talk this afternoon. Please, whenever your mom comes for Omugwo, Omugwo is that visit that mothers come after the wife just had a baby. Please tell your mothers that they are not coming for holiday. No, if your mom wants to go on vacation, maybe you should send her to Dubai. That period after child delivery, she needs your mom to come and assist her with taking care of you and the baby. Yes. Because if your mom comes and she's not helping your wife, then she's been a liability on that wife. Because you're not at home to see the things that are going on. How can a mother say she's here for Omugwo and the wife is the one cooking, cleaning, brushing, scrubbing, bathing the baby and all of that? What is your mother doing? It's better for her not to come. And a lot of you men won't even allow your wife to bring their home mom. If you know that your mom is coming for vacation and she's not coming to help with the baby, please allow your wife's mother come and help her. It is tiring enough that after having children, we have to take care of those children, take care of you, the men. You will now still go and bring your mother again. A lot of mother-in-laws will see that as an opportunity to come and stretch their legs and drink cold Bonvita and plenty milk. All the food that is meant for mommy baby, grandma will finish everything. And grandma will not even go on time. She will stay there until she's not robust. Grandma will be becoming fatty. Baby's mommy will be looking thin and tattered. It is not fair. Please, we understand that it is rude of your wife to face your mom. But you as the man, stand up for your wife in this situation. Let your mom understand her role. Let her know that she's there to help your wife. It is sad. I read a story this afternoon and I won't lie to you, it's really, really scared me. This lady had a baby three weeks ago through C-section. So the mother-in-law had to travel down to the village, from the village. This lady begged her husband, please let my mom come so that I'll be able to beg my mom to do things for me. He said, lie, my mom has to come. The mother-in-law came. Can you believe that this lady will wake up as early as 5 a.m., get the older child ready, bath for the new baby, C-section of 3 weeks. The mother-in-law will stretch her legs. Whenever she wakes up, she will even say she wants pounded yam. The mother-in-law will be asking for foods that are so difficult to make. It is not fair. 3 weeks C-section. Please, it is time for you to table this matter to your mom, especially if you know that you fall in this category of men, men that don't like to confront their mothers. Please, table this matter very well. Let your mom know her roles and her duties, because a lot of mothers see it as an opportunity to come and stretch their legs. They will say they are going for Omugwo, but no, it is vacation. But no, it is indirect holiday. It is not fair on your wives. Please, mothers, whenever you go to your in-laws' house, please now, assist that poor girl. It is somebody that gave birth to her. How would you feel if your own daughter calls you and tells you that is what her mother-in-law is doing to her after C-section? Please, oh, we need to discuss this a lot, because I think a lot of women are suffering silently, and it is only unfair of us if everybody keeps quiet. Thank you and God bless.
At the end of the day, as far as I know, Omugwo, it is the woman's mother. It was traditionally, traditionally, it was a way for the mother to not only be there for her daughter that just had a baby and care for her and all of that, but it's also a way a mother comes to pass on the parenting skill or mothering skills. The way that the mothers were to pass on the mothering skills, as in motherly skills, to their daughters. That was another one. Another one is the aspect of what about the you know, the pressing of the belly with hot water and all those things that only your mother, you really typically will be more comfortable your mother doing it. You know, in our culture where a woman just had a baby, they press hot water and all of that. A woman can easily strip naked for them, for her own mother, compared to her husband's mother, right? So it used to be a way for a mother and daughter is only when, if the woman's mother is already gone, like dead, that even in some cultures, even if the woman's mother is dead, maybe an auntie from the mother's side, they typically, from the wife's side, the auntie, you know, and stuff like that. If there's no other option, then I go to the mother of the man. But some cultures, if the mother is not available, the mother is unwell or too old or is gone, dead, the husband's mother. But the wife's mother is always the first point of call. It's always the first option. And another aspect people have to realize is that when a woman's mother comes, it's easier for a woman to misbehave to her mother. If you know what I mean by misbehave, isn't it? There are some things that you may do to a mother-in-law that will be seen as disrespectful. But with your own mother, it's not called disrespectful. If body they pepper, you go, no, to your mother. You know they pay for body. Your mother may be more understanding that, oh, my daughter just had a baby, body they pepper her, she's irritated. But if you do it to your mother-in-law, to be disrespectful. You see what I'm trying to say? So, I don't know, because I feel like some men see it as, I'm going to spend money on a visa, I'm going to spend money on flights, I'm going to spend, let me keep it in my family. Or is the opportunity for my mother to, for my mother to, your mother can come later. You know, traditionally how it's done, even if you want your mother to even come and see the baby too, it's okay. Oh, I really want her to come, that's fine. But the mother of the bride, that 6 months of Omugwo belongs to the wife. Because it is, I know we're talking about equality, that's true. But when it comes to equality, when it comes to the fact that it is the woman's body that has to, it is the woman's body that just produced a baby. It is her body and her needs that are more important than anything else. Even when we speak about equality, you understand? So it's not the son that gave birth. That the, okay, your mother is coming because now you as a man gave birth. So you understand that aspect. It's important. The understanding is it. And that's why we make videos like this. For men to sit down and process it. Oh, I lost my train of thought there. So if you want your mother to come as a man, that's fine. When your wife's mother has come and done her 6 months, when she's gone, traditionally that's how it's done. The mother, two of them cannot come at the same time. Some people may be able to do it. But as far as I know, the two of them are not, culturally are not allowed to be in that house at the same time. So the mother of the bride can come and do the 6 months. After she's gone, the mother of the, I keep saying bride as if we're talking about wedding, of the wife. And then the mother of the man then can come. Let's not forget. I think when people focus on why it's being done, it helps people to not beat around the bush and drag the matter and complicate it. Why is Omugwo being done? The woman's healing process. So there's so much that is being done that ideally it is the mother of the bride that, as a mother and child, is easier to, you know, strip naked for your mother and a lot of the things. What about the mothers that we check to see your stitches? Do you know what I'm trying to say? So focus on that. And at the end, I'm talking about the why. It is to make sure the mother and the baby that just came to the world are being looked after. You understand? Because when your mother comes, you know, traditionally you're supposed to be caring. Traditionally, you cannot be sending your mother-in-law message, mama, go boil me rice, na rice I want chop. But you can tell your mother, mama, boil me rice, na rice I want chop. You can. But mama, change the diaper. If there's a mother-in-law like me, you call the same message. I'm using me as a slave. You understand what I'm trying to say? So all these things, the confusion that we end up coming out of it, they're all preventable if people focus on the why. And like I said, at the end of the 6 months, to have your baby to have become 6 months old and all the necessities and all the necessary help that were needed were given at that time, I think if that's the focus, it will prevent all the conflicts that may come from it. You know, there's no reason why a woman that just had a baby, you know, should be caring for herself, caring for baby, and start caring for you, and start caring for your mother as well. It's too much now. It's too much. That's in my opinion anyways about it. As always, whatever your opinions are, please leave them in the comment section below. With that, I'm going to say thank you for watching. Until the next time, guys. Bye-bye. Bye.